born September 18th, 1923 in Weed, California, which is 60 miles from the Oregon border in Siskiyou County, California. My mother, Bertha Ann McLaughlin, was born in Redding, October 26, 1896, and my father, George Gilbert Murphy, was born December 19, 1897 in Shasta County. They were married in Wairika, I know that. I was born on a ranch where my dad, grandfather, J.J. Murphy, and my dad's brother, Arch Murphy, ran cattle for Longbell Lumber Company at Weed. In 1924, Longbell went out of the cattle business, and my dad and mother moved to Tennant, which was a logging camp 40 miles from Weed, 13 miles off Highway 97. And my dad was a railroad engineer hauling logs for Longbell Lumber Company. I left in 1939, turned 16 in September, and some of us were able to go to Wairika, which was a much bigger school. My father died April 26, 1940, and my mother stayed in Tennant and moved to Wairika very shortly after. I lived 1 year with my Aunt Evelyn, and she was married to Ernest Lilly. I stayed with them, went to high school, worked at the Broadway Grocery after school and on Saturdays for $5 a week. She had turned 99 in September, and she died just before Christmas in 2002. She was in her 100th year. She was 99 in 2 months.
I grew up dreaming.
When I first got to Sacramento, Robert Murphy got me a job at Cal Western in the mailroom, and I was going to junior college. Then I met Mike Concannon, who was also worked in the mailroom, and his family offered me to come out and live with them in June of 41, which I did. And on December 7th, 1941, Japan attacked Honolulu. Of course, we all ran down. We're going to join right up, but there was already a draft, and they were getting people in. So we went to work in the shipyards at Richmond, California. And we were all drafted on the same day, January 26, 1943. They shipped me to Buckley Field, Colorado. They were training me to be an armorer, load bombs, load guns. They formed there the 83rd Aerodrome Squadron. There's about 350 of us. They loaded us on the Queen Mary out of New York Harbor, 18,000 of us, which went so fast that the convoy couldn't keep up with it. So we were traveling, on the sea by ourselves. The initial invasion of Omaha and Utah Beach for the Americans was in June 6, 1944. So we arrived at the debarkation point on the 12th, and they wanted to know, where have you been? You were supposed to be here 3 days ago. So they fed us, gave us invasion money, and loaded us on a landing craft infantry, and we crossed the channel and landed at Omaha Beach on the 13th of June, 1944. Of course, the fighting by then was basically inland, 4 or 5 miles all over the place, but great confusion. we were the first guys to operate an airstrip in France. So one time they sent us out looking for an airplane, a downed airplane in Alsace-Lorraine. There was about five of us in a old command car. We crossed the river, and pretty soon here comes a jeep roaring behind us, and it was a second lieutenant. Where are you going? He was, we're looking for a downed airplane. Well, you can't go any farther up here because 4 kilometers of the German, there's nobody in between. So we turned around and we went back to Luxembourg City. And we're in a bar up in Luxembourg City, drinking away, having a good time. And that was the night that the Battle of the Bulge started. And they were picking up everybody they could find and putting them in the front lines. But they missed us. We're in the bar. Those poor Luxembourgers didn't know whether to wave an American flag or a German flag. So I felt a little sorry for them. But anyway, the 83rd Airdrome Squadron that I had gone over with and all these guys that I'd spent a couple of years with, they came back on, I think it was the Enterprise aircraft carrier, and I got on the Queen Mary, and I could have had the same bunk, entirely different outfit, that I had going over. That was the end of the war.
Did you get that Maureen in that?